testimonies. And we've been talking about the goodness of God and how God can save and how he can deliver and how he can heal us. Because believe it or not, we all have some place in our life that's hurting. And it's so awesome that we've been talking about testimonies, because you know what? I was telling my husband before I get going, just blasting out the gate, I just want to acknowledge the man of God in this house, Apostle Shirley. Come on and give him a hand praise. His lovely, lovely, lovely wife. Hallelujah. I want to bless God for my friend, Sister Sherry. You are my friend, sis. And I love you too. Hallelujah. But I tell you what, before I came, my husband is not with me, but before I came to minister tonight, he said, well, baby, what you gonna do? What you gonna sing when you get down there? Because I asked Brother Garvin to come in, Bishop Garvin, to come over. And I asked him, come on, let's just worship a little bit prophetically. So that's what we were doing in our house. And the Spirit of God came in our house right there as we began to worship him. And he said, well, what are you going to sing? Is that all you going to sing? I said, if that's all he give me to sing, that's what I'm going to sing. Because I have learned you better do what he said do. Has anybody found that out? Just do what he says. Just do what God says. Because even the trip is shorter, it's easier. You ain't got to go all around the turns and hooks and bends and all that. Amen. Come on and just lift your hands up to God. Tonight we're just going to worship. From where we are, we're going to worship from this place. And as we worship, I just want to say that a lot of people don't know, but worship is not the song. And the Lord told me that when I came in here to let you know, to tell you that your worship is relevant in the kingdom of God. But worship is not the song. The song is the end of my worship. It's after I've given up. So worship is a lifestyle. It's after I've submitted to God behind the scene. It's after I've not touched the thing he told me don't touch. It's after I really wanted to go there, but he said don't, and I did. It's after that. That's worship. Come on, somebody say, I am your worshiper. Well, come on, just get your mind on Jesus tonight. And I'm just going to sing prophetically tonight because I believe that it is a right now worship. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, lift those eyes and just close your. Come on, just lift your hands and close your eyes and forget about everybody. Forget about me. Forget about everybody. I want you to hear. Let God's voice be the loudest voice you hear tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Oh. She worships the place I fall apart, the place he mends all of my hurt and fixes my broken heart. Oh, worship is the place that I made whole. to glory. His glory, just lift your hands and sing. Yeah, don't look at me. try to say, okay, well then the word says this, but I'm living like that. And God, you said I ought to be doing this, but I'm doing that. And so I begin to line my life up with the word of God. Because I need his glory. We come all the way from Amarillo, and I'm not playing with the devil. And I don't care if who worships, who don't. I don't care who get with it, who don't. But I need the glory of God on my life for my baby. And if the truth be told, you got somebody you need the glory of God for. Can you just lift your hands for them, not for you? Can you just lift your hands for them? Come on, for that daughter that's strung out. Hallelujah. Come on, for that son that's gangbanging and all lost and don't know, suffering with a sexual identity. Can you lift your hand to receive the glory of God for them? Thank you, God. Come on, that's it. Come on, everybody, just begin to cry out to him. Come on, I don't know who it is that you need God to touch. Come on, that's it. Come on, get it. That's it.